Okay, we're back. And if you're thinking, wait, this isn't unreal, you're absolutely right. We've got our stage set, right? We've built our level, we've imported all of our stuff, we have all of our inputs all set up and ready to go. And now we're ready to start building our game in earnest. However, before we do that, I wanted to take just a moment and give you a quick refresher, maybe not a refresher, maybe this is the first time you've ever heard this, a quick rundown of the Unreal framework specifically as it pertains to this project. So if you're new to this, this is probably something you'll want to write down and have handy. If you've heard it all before, you might want to skip this video, but maybe you'll hear something interesting. Who knows? So the idea is that there are a series of classes that make up Unreal. So you have, basically whenever you create something, it is going to be based on one of these existing classes. And it's important to know what some of the key classes are and why we need them, how we're going to use them. So the first one of these is an actor. Well, the first one that we care about, there's actually object over this, but we're not going to do anything with object. We're going to start off with actor. And an actor is anything that is placed in your world. So, if it can live in your 3D world, it is going to be some kind of actor. Period, end of story. Now, down from actor, so kind of descending from that, we have a pawn class. And a pawn is anything that can be controlled. Now, what do I mean when I say controlled? Well, something can drive it around the world. It could be a player with sitting in its living room, in his living room with a controller driving something around, kind of like we're going to be doing, except I'm not in a living room. I'm in a little sound booth right now. It could be an AI algorithm, which is driving this thing around. So a pawn could be a character in your game. It could be a vehicle. It could be a fish. Anything that has any kind of you can't see my finger quotes, but trust me, I'm using them. Any kind of brain that is going to be used to give this thing some sort of life or behavior, that it's going to be based off of a pawn. Now, a pawn is still an actor, so it's based upon actor. That's how programming class hierarchies work. So we start from actor, then we descend down to pawn. So a pawn gets all of the same properties as an actor, but it adds some other stuff. It adds the ability to be controlled. Now, down from that, we have the concept of a character. Now, a character is a pawn, and a pawn is an actor. So a character can be placed in the world, and it can be controlled, but it's a special type of pawn that has some things to make bipedal-style characters, maybe not necessarily bipedal, but anything roughly humanoid is going to be easier to create if it's a character. And that's because a character class includes a slot to put a skeletal mesh, like the actual mesh you might create in 3ds Max or Maya or Blender or whatever sort of 3D animation package you use to create a 3D asset. So you can put that inside of a character. It also has a little physics capsule that'll go around your character so that he can calculate collisions, so that things coming into the world can bounce off of him, which is super useful. And I got an extra line there. So what I meant to draw was something like this, which is bouncing off of his physics capsule. Now, it also has a special component inside of it, and I'll go into that word in a minute. It has a character movement component. And that's a lot of words to have to write out. So a character movement component is this special little thing, we'll keep it simple for now, that controls how fast the character can move and run and jump and how high he can jump and how he navigates. Basically, it controls all of his getting through the world behavior. It's also aware of things like if he's swimming, if he's falling, so that you can tap into those and use them to make transitions in animation. Now, that brings up another word that doesn't necessarily fall directly into our list, but is super important, and that is a component. So what is a component? A component, as I kind of break out of my list real quick, is part of an actor. So that because they can be in actors, they can be in pawns, they can be in characters, because of inheritance, everybody kind of gets all of their parents' properties. So you can just think of a component as a building block. It's just, here, we'll write that one down. building block. Each component is going to have its own contained functionality. So some components, like the character movement component, are just there to help you do a specific thing, like move a character around. But there are lots of other components too. There are light components that allow an object to emit light into the world. There are collision components so that it can collide with things. In fact, that's what the little capsule around our character is going to be. Now, we're going to be adding all kinds of components to our objects while we build them in Unreal. We're going to add things like cameras and spring arms and our own types of collision and mesh components and all kinds of stuff as we go forward. But it's important to note that actors, or any object that can live in your game, is going to be comprised of, built up, out of components. Now, there are some other classes. So component's kind of a special case, right? Because he's sort of like his own little extra part that is going to build up everything that you see. Now, there's some other classes that we're not going to worry about in terms of where they go in the chain. We're going to discuss them sort of separately because they're still going to be important and we're still going to be interacting with them in some way throughout this project. So we have a controller. Now, there are actually two kinds of controllers that we care about. There are player controllers and there are AI controllers. Now, what is a controller? Well, a controller is just a control mechanism that drives a pawn. It is basically the driving force which pushes a pawn around and influences it. When you are when you're sitting there with your controller and you're waggling the joysticks around and mashing buttons and whatnot, you are generally going to be communicating with the player controller. Now, that does not mean that all of the functionality for how you handle inputs needs to be placed in the player controller. And this gets a little deep, so I don't want you to think too hard about it right now if you're a beginner. If you've been playing with Unreal for a while, you can look up more about this in our documentation. So a player controller can and often does, hold all of the input functionality for your game, especially if your game is going to have a lot of players all playing at the same time and a lot of different kinds of characters that you can control. In that case, you're going to handle all your inputs through the player controller, and then the player controller will send kind of generic signals out to your actual character or pawn to make it do stuff. Now, our game is going to be super simple, so we're hardly going to touch the player controller. It's just important to know that it exists. It's important to know that we can get data from it. For example, the player controller is going to be aware of all of the rotations being sent down to our pawn. And so later on, we're going to ask our controller what the rotation of our character is so that we know which way it's facing. So it's a little... It's easy to explain, but it's easier if you've been doing it for a while. So just talking about it here, it's important for you to hear about it because then like you'll kind of have a little bit of the information stuck in your head. Hopefully you're taking notes so that you'll actually see this later as we move through the project. Now, an AI controller is really just an AI brain. It is an entirely, I'll try to draw a brain. This is like the worst brain ever. Yeah, doesn't that look kind of brain? That doesn't look like a brain at all. Okay. We could do like the brainstem hanging off the back. That makes it more apparent, right? So an AI controller is just a brain that you can plug into a pawn to make it drive around. So we're going to be creating one of those two, but keep in mind that the AI we're going to create is super, super simple. It's about as basic as you can make it. No, before you ask, we're not going to be delving into behavior trees or anything complex like that. Though, what we're setting up kind of paves the way for that. So if you wanted to have more complex AI, the groundwork would be in place for you to be able to do that. Okay, so the next little class I wanted to talk about is a game mode. Now, a game mode you can think of simply as the rules for your game. That's it. It is going to tell your game what character should the player be using when they play the game. Like, what is the default character? You know, if you were playing, like a Gears of War game, the default character might be Marcus Fenix. If you were playing, that's a prime example, right? But you're going to tell the game mode what pawn you're going to use to play the game. You're going to tell it what type of player controller you're going to use, because you might define your own custom player controller, so you'll tell it that as well, along with a bunch of other properties. Now, the game mode is also a good place to store any data or functionality that is going to transcend all of your different levels. Basically, so here's a good example, right? Maybe you're playing a game that has a score, which is something we're gonna have. So where do you store the score? If you store it on the character and the character ever gets deleted, like maybe that's how you handle death, then you lose that value. But if you have that score stored way up in the game mode, which kind of lives way up above everybody, then that's gonna be retained for later as you continue playing the game. So it's just kind of like, it's the rules of the game. It lives completely separate from your character and everything else. Now, let's see, was there anything else I really wanted to hit on? I feel like there was one, but I'm actually drawing a little bit of a blank. So we've got our controller, we've got our game mode. I think those are all of the major classes that we're going to need. So with that, I think we can go ahead and start building our first character. If we run into any other classes that we need, then I will touch on those when we get to them, and I'll explain what they do from there. So that will wrap things up for this video. Thanks a lot.